How to factor a polynomial of four or more terms. The method we're going to use is called grouping. We're going to form some groups, factor each of our groups, look for a common binomial, check to see if our factors go further. Let's look at a specific example. So here we have a polynomial with four terms. There is no greatest common factor for all four terms, so we're going to try grouping. What we do is that we form groups first. Forming groups consists of just putting in parentheses where they belong. So I'm going to group the first two terms together, and I'm going to group the last two terms together. So I've just put in parentheses, and what I have is equal to the original. Now, I notice that each of my groups does have a common factor to distribute out. So my first group, I can distribute out an x squared, and I have, and I'm going to write this in red, x minus 3. And my next group, I have a common factor of 2, and so I have x minus 3. Now the reason I've written that in red is to emphasize that, look what we have left. We have this and this are exactly the same. So you can think of this as a polynomial with two terms. Just think of it as two terms for a little while. There's one, and there's two, and they have a common factor. They have an x minus 3. So what do we do with the x minus 3? We distribute out the x minus 3, and what's left? X squared plus 2. So the x minus 3's got distributed out, and then x squared plus 2 is what's left. So your final answer is just x minus 3 times x squared plus 2. Now let's try an example where there's a negative in between my groups. So what that's going to change is right away, I'm going to notice it's four terms, so I know that I'm going to use grouping. And when I go to add the parentheses, I notice that x cubed plus 8x squared, I'm going to put a negative between my groups. So what does my next group need to consist of? A 3x plus 24. It's as if we're distributing out a negative 1. We're not going to write that negative 1, but it's as if it's there. Now we have two groups. Factor each of your groups. Take out the common factor in each group. So my first group has an x squared as a common factor. What's left? X plus 8. My next group has a 3. What's left? X plus 8. Notice these are both x plus 8s. They are exactly alike. And so when I distribute them out, I get x plus 8 times what's left, x squared minus 3. And I'm done. I've written my original polynomial as a multiplication. Now, what will happen sometimes is you will get this far, and let's say these aren't exactly alike. What do you do if your binomials aren't exactly alike? Well, you can't proceed. You can't distribute out something unless it's exactly alike. So what you need to do is go back to the beginning and rearrange your terms. Maybe if you put the 8x squared here and the 3x here, it will all end up being in the right order.